What's going on, everybody? We are coming at you with another news vid. It's been a while since our last news vid, but so much has happened with the world championships. That's a pretty big deal, something that happened over the weekend. And then some DLC announcements. We've got a lot to talk about. We got a kind of a shorter vid today, but we're just going to dive right in. Guys, if you enjoyed this video or any of our content, like, comment, subscribe. We'll get back to our regular upload schedule now that vacations and huge disc golf tournaments are not a thing. But for more updates on that, wait till the podcast on Friday. Anyway, let's get into the news.
What's going on, Pokemon fans? Gym Leader Justin here. We're just coming at you with a quick video, not too long. We're just going to cover some of the news that happened over Worlds. There's a lot that's been announced, a lot of trailers and cool stuff. We talked about some of the stuff about Unite on the podcast, which will be coming out this Friday. Check that out. We're not a huge Unite stuff, but for those of you who are excited, definitely go check that out when it comes out. But they did announce three new Pokemon for Pokemon Unite, but we're talking about some news here today. What do we got here? Well, we have all the starters are coming back for Area Zero. So you can go check the trailer and all that. We're not going to do all that here, obviously, and watch all those. There's a couple different videos on their website. But over here, we do have this nice poster. Every single starter is going to be coming out in the Area Zero DLC. So that's really, really exciting. Really cool stuff. Some of these haven't been around for a while. Like I know Mike, PMC Joseph G, one of the top four council members here. He loves Superior Snivy. So seeing Contrary Snake come back for a long time is going to be really cool. I'm obviously super stoked to see my boy Sceptile. Brandon's excited for Venusaur. Very, very cool stuff. Everybody loves Incineroar. He's great in the meta just overall. Swampert's going to be great. Pickle's coming back. Chimchar, let's go. Like, there's so much to be excited for. Dougie's really excited for the Blastoise. I know is really excited for Primarina in competitive. The Piplup. Cool Penguin, too. So lots of good stuff here. We love to see all of these starters returning so we can just catch them in-game. Don't have to worry about transfer. We just have them in game and we can use them in our battles.
Had the VGC TCG World Championships. Maybe Pokemon Go was a part of that. I don't know. I don't follow Pokemon Go. Let me know in the comments if it was a part of it. World Championships over in Japan. Really, really eventful. As far as top cuts go, I just want to look over some of these teams. Obviously, Shohei Kimura, pardon me if I butchered that name, our world champion, a Japan native. So that's really cool to see someone in their home city take down the world championship. $10,000 and an automatic berth into the 2024 world championships, as well as the rest of the top four cut. All these guys taking home a decent amount of change, $7,500 for second, $5,000 for third, and $5,000 for fourth as well. As far as the teams go, the thing that stands out to me, Urshifu Rapid Strike on every single team in the top eight here. Urshifu Rapid. These are, there's a single strike, pardon me. But he's one of the most consistent Pokemon right now. The Rapid Strike and the single strike form, just double dip TERAs for massive damage, crit through screens. There's a reason you're seeing a little less Grimmsnarl up in these top cuts right now, because without the HP swelling from Dynamax, this thing can just crit through whatever and crit through Protect. So it doesn't make a lot of sense to run screens right now, I feel like, in Regulation D with this thing being so strong and just kind of running the metagame right now. Everything else across the board looking pretty standard. Outside of the second place team had a Dragapult and a Heatran and a Ferrigarath. So three Pokemon there. Really, really high placement at a world championship event. Rillaboom still seeing, we got 1, 2, 3 Rillabooms in the top eight. Really, really exciting to see. I know my boy Justin is so excited about that. But then, the rest of the roster, there's a lot of really consistent options here. I see a lot of Iron Hands for those fake out and volt switches. So you can cycle your fake outs and force some protects or force some flinches. Chen Pao goes really well with Urshifu, so you're seeing Chen Pao 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of the top eight teams. Then Intimidate Shenanigans, see a couple Landorus here on the top team, and number eight. And then Rain from Pelipper coming in and the number 5 slot. So honestly, it's a lot of pretty standard stuff, but this is the World Championships, you know what I mean? We're not taking the off-meta picks into the World Championships and trying to take it down there. So it's really cool to see all the flags here and see all the different countries represented in a World Championships. This was truly like a really cool melting pot of players and teams. Seeing Ursaluna, yeah. Seeing a little bit of Sun. We're going to talk about weather on an upcoming podcast, so don't forget to check that out. You know what I mean? We're seeing some pretty interesting stuff. You know, we got Wochain. We're seeing, oh, Joe UX9, of course. Wochain's strongest soldier. We're seeing a lot of really, really interesting stuff here after we get out of the top 8. So there's some screens finally down here. Intimidate with Arcanine Hisuian. Yeah, but really, really strong looking teams here. And once again, congrats to Shohei Kimura for the World Championship.
And then also, we have another really awesome piece of news here. A 19th Terra type has been discovered. So it's not a 19th type. It's only a Terra type. And we have this rainbow icon. So it's like rainbow type, basically. I don't know. We'll see. And now the hidden treasure of Area Zero, Pokemon Scarlet Violet, and new Terra type has been discovered. A 19th Terra type. Something about it seems different from the 18th. Terra types we've seen so far, but much is yet unknown. What is the truth behind the 19th Terra type? Oh boy. So yeah, there's not a lot here. It's pretty exciting. We have this rainbow icon. It's absolutely gorgeous. Not really sure what it's gonna mean yet. It's not on the new turtle. So it's on just a regular poke on this Baxcalibur. Anybody can do it. Probably a DLC thing. It's really interesting. Like, maybe there's no weakness. Maybe it's super effective against everything. Maybe, I don't know. There's some crazy stuff going on here, man. I really, really dig it. So, really happy to see them implementing some new stuff. At least gives us some new toys to play with. Pretty cool, honestly. But wait, there's more. There's also some new moves. Because they just like to spoil us, I guess. We do have some cool new moves. I think it's pretty interesting. Hold Fierce Battles using the new moves Upper Hand and Psychic Noise. New move Upper Hand. With this fighting type physical move, the user reacts to the target's movements and strikes with the heel of its palm. Pretty cool. I like that they have Hariyama in there. Getting a nice arm thrust. If the target was trying to use a priority move, Upper Hand will get the jump on them, allowing the user to target first, causing the opponent to flinch without fail. The move will fail if the target wasn't readying a priority move. So obviously this is good against things like other fake out users, bullet punch, obviously, as we see here with Caesar, mock punch will be coming big, especially as we just talked about with my boy Chimchar. So there are some definitely good priority users in the game. Still up in the air how this will work with Sucker Punch. New move, Psychic Noise. Zero's gonna be excited about this. This psychic type special move deals damage as it bashes the target in an abrasive sound waves. This attack also prevents the target from recovering HP through moves, abilities, or items for a certain number of turns. So it shuts off healing. Very, very cool. He screams at him and then shuts off healing. I kind of dig it. I like that they're showing off Gardevoir again, giving me more of those Hoenn reps. I really like both of these new moves. They're pretty, pretty legit.
So now the other sort of unfortunate news that came out of the World Championships was a lot of players got disqualified for using hacked Pokemon. You know, whether that be something you got from a mystery trade or maybe it was Gen or something like that. Or maybe a lot of these players probably didn't even know. But that was a huge deal at the World Championships. I know it made a lot of waves. It's something I think TPCI decided to crack down at this event. I think they're a lot more strict about it in Japan than they are like at a regional level, especially like here in America. But really interesting to see and really unfortunate for a lot of players who, you know, spent the time, spent the money to go to Japan and compete in this championship just for them to be disqualified for having hacked Pokemon. So it is a really weird spot. I kind of see both of them. I really want to know you guys' opinion. Gym Leader Justin and I and PMC Spork Ninja, we had a really long, passionate discussion about the pros and the cons of this and who's really at fault Ultimately, it seems like it's just kind of spotty enforcement from the Pokemon company. But at the same time, you know, from the player side, it's like we got warnings at the beginning of Gen 9 to not use hacked Pokemon. So it's like there's a lot of things at play here, a lot of things that factor. The bottom line is that the whole situation is just super unfortunate. And at the end of the day, I know me personally, just let the players play. You know, like I'm a player. PMC, you know, gym leader Justin, he's a player. Sporting, he's a player. We're all players. You know, there's more of us who are playing this event than there are running it. So I think we all, a lot of us kind of stand in that boat where it's like, okay, just let him play. You know, if my adamant Urshifu Dark that I bought from some hacker does the same amount of damage as a legit Urshifu, you know, what's the difference? But that's a whole can of worms that we could talk about for a really long time. So leave a comment, guys. Let us know what you think of this whole situation with the World Championship disqualifications. It was a big fiasco. Let us know in the comments what you think below.
And then obviously it's already been going around the internet, taking it by storm, but they did announce newly discovered Paradox Pokemon in Paldea, Raging Bolt and Iron Crown. So again, much like we already had with Iron Leaves and Walking Wake, the Justice Trio or whatever are coming from the future, and then the legendary beasts are coming from the past. So pretty cool here. We have this Brontosaurus giraffe cat thing. It's pretty cool. Apparently it's based off of a Doug told me this, so shout out PMC Sport Ninja, did some cool research. It's based on Mesopotamian mythology. Anyway, some sort of mythology where it's basically like this long-tailed, long-neck leopard. It's like a seropod, I think is what it's called. And then obviously keeping along the dinosaur theme, you know, big Brontosaurus with the disc around his neck, much like Horizon Zero Dawn. Very, very fun here. And then you can see when he attacks, the cloud kind of unfrills from the disc around his neck, and you can see that he's still got the cat face, so kind of that seropod look there. And then I actually really, really dig the Iron Crown when he turns there, and he's got that long curved antelope kind of look with his horns there. I dig that. If that's what he looks like in game, that's pretty legit for me. And I like Cobalion. Cobalion's very, very strong poke competitively, very good justified poke because he's that steel fighting, so pretty legit. I'm excited to have him back in the game. I'm excited to have Raikou back in the game. Raikou, sorry, I don't really know how to pronounce it. And then I don't know. So it's been pretty divisive about this dinosaur form. I like it. Raging Bolt is a two thumbs up and a smile from me. Like, I think this is cool. So
I gotta sneak back into the video, guys. Raging Bolt, signature move, Thunderclap. We don't have a base power, but this move strikes before the opponent. So we're guessing this is gonna be like a priority move. I'm assuming it's gonna be an electric type. It'd be really, really interesting to see coming from this dragon and electric type. And then Iron Crown, signature move, Tachyon Cutter, guaranteed to hit twice. So in the video, you'll see they'll break the disguise on a Mimikyu, and then they will strike again with Tachyon Cutter and knock the Pokemon out. Could be an interesting move. I think maybe if it ends up being Steel over something like Psychic, I think it would be a lot more powerful. Just remains to be seen. I think it'll be Steel because we already got, you know, the new Psychic move coming from this DLC. So two really interesting moves. I think they're going to be pretty strong. Not sure how game defining they'll be until we get them in the game. It'll be interesting to see. All right, back to Justin. I'll let him wrap it up.
And like I said, there is the video here, which you can watch. Go over there. The link will be in the description to where you can find it if you want to go click that. We'll not, you know, do it here. I already watched it. Not like a reveal thing if I've already seen it, but that's okay. It's just going to go over some of the stuff that we covered here, but it's kind of cool to see their subpar graphics in 2023. It's kind of funny, but what it is kind of cool is that for Pokemon fans, we do get a lot of these starters back, and starters are the nostalgia bait. So have you seen all this news yet? Have you checked it all out? What do you think about the starters coming back? What's your favorite starter? Let us know down in the comments below. Also, what do you think about Raging Bolt, and what do you think about the Iron Crown? Let us know in the comments below. Thumbs up, thumbs down. Let us know what do you think about them aesthetically. If you did make it to the end of this video, I really appreciate it. Thank you so much. We are coming back next week with the back to our normal scheduled podcast and battle videos and everything else for Regulation D, as well as a whole bunch of card content. So go check out our new podcast that will come out this Friday. And let us know in those comment section what do you think about some of the questions that we asked about the card content. But thank you so much. Subscribe to the channel, thumbs up, and we'll catch you on the next one.
Peace.